He's been writing songs and playing music all across the country for more than 30 years. And just like everyone else, Willie Porter's performances came to a giant halt with the arrival of COVID-19.
Yeah, I moved over to my musical studio in honor of Willie. We are thrilled to catch up with Willie this morning to see how things are going. Hey, Willie Porter, how are you?
Good to see you, Willie.
Good morning, my friends. How are you? I'm doing well.
It's so great to see you.
Yeah,
it's great to see you as well.
For joining us. How are you doing and how's your family?
Everybody is well here. You know, we've all adapted to this this new environment in a way, and it's brought its own challenges, but it's brought some rewards as well.
You know, one of the things that's interesting, Willie, is when we've talked to musicians who are home during this time, they're used to traveling a lot, and we know you travel a ton. And so it's been a challenge for many musicians to be at home. How has it been for you just actually being at home and not being able to travel and do music?
Well, when I was dating my girlfriend, now wife of many, many years, she said to me, the reason that our relationship seems to work so well is that you go away from time to time. So this has been a very strong litmus test, and we've come through it very well, I'd say. So that's a great thing about it. It has put a big test on a lot of relationships. And I think we've all dug in a little bit deeper to try to make those things improve.
Good for you. I know one of the themes in your music, among many other cool themes, is relationship repair. Yeah. And I appreciate the honesty in your music, and I love so many of the themes. And I wonder, because you travel a lot, was there anything you were looking forward to doing in 2020 that you haven't been able to do, that you didn't do because we've been shut down?
Yes. Speaking again to the travel side of it, I don't miss the travel at all. I miss the music. I miss the being in the rooms and playing music with people, particularly the band and so forth. But yeah, I had to cancel my Ireland trip, which has become an annual trip for me, and unfortunately. And there was so much summer touring. I always look forward to Summerfest and a lot of regional festivals and stuff that we participate in. So a lot of that has gone away. And but I think, you know, wisely so. We have no idea really what the ultimate outcome of this thing is going to be. And so I salute the promoters and such for being cautious.
Yeah, I think that's smart. It's sad, you know, for a lot of us trying to see musicians. We can see people online, which has helped. You know, there's so many kids, I think, too, that are missing out. Think about back to your days at Homestead High. You were in bands and musicals. What was it like for you? What kind of kid were you? And can you even imagine not being able to play in all those things that you were loving as a kid?
You know, I really was very, very fortunate. There was a great band director there. And though I didn't participate in the orchestra and such, I was allowed to rehearse and use their spaces to work on the music that I was working on. And so it was a really rich environment. And I think I'm thankful for that every day, that I had the teachers that I had, some great academic instruction as well as great art instruction, and just, real empowerment for, young kids back then. It was a great way to grow up.
I wonder, because I think regardless of what profession we're in, we're often approached by young people who say, oh, I want to do just what you do. And I bet you get that a lot, Willie. And I'm just wondering, what do you tell kids, and maybe your own kids, because are both of your kids musical?
They are, yes.
Okay.
Basically, yeah, my main instruction is, if you want to play music that you love first. Try to play the stuff that you really like. You'll be much more invested in it. It will come much easier to you. Rehearsal will be much more fun than if you're trying to, learn scales or right away jump into some difficult classical piece. If that's what your calling is, if that's what your heart tells you to do, then go for it. But otherwise, stick to music that is in your heart already, and skill acquisition is much simpler that way.
I always think it's interesting when musicians are kind of largely self-taught, like you are as well. But there's so many good resources, I feel like, for kids. And I'm amazed at, like, the kids that learn online and from watching YouTube videos or, online apps and things like that. I mean, it's a real interesting thing. Do you feel that if someone's just got music in them, it naturally is going to find a way out?
I really do. I think it's an undeniable force in a young person for sure. And either even friends of mine who have started in much later in life find that it's easy to grab. But there's so, if you're self-directed, you can do anything you want to do today. It's all available to you, which is just incredibly empowering.
Tell us a little bit about your Facebook. Yeah, I love it. Your Facebook Live concerts. How you decide what to play, what kind of reaction you've had.
It's been wonderful. I look at them as each one of those one-hour shows is just kind of a gift to be free and open, and you don't get to see an audience reaction. And early on, that was a bit daunting. And now I see it's very liberating because you can really invest in the interior of the music more. And by that, I mean, you can stretch things out and play a 15-minute improvisation if you want to. It doesn't mean people are going to stay tuned in, but you could you can go as far as you want and reimagine things. So music that you've always heard to be one form, particularly pop music, those forms no longer have to be maintained. You can change them, alter the keys. So I've had a lot of fun with it.
It's cool. I feel like it's been really intimate to watch musicians in their own space and kind of riff, like you said. I can't imagine, though. It's got to be hard to make up new music now. I mean, in your mind, are you like, have I heard this somewhere before? Is this truly coming out of me? Is that hard?
Well, I think there's a great saying that, you know, everything that can be said has been said. It's just a matter of timbre, and it's a matter of, and how you spin it. So if you get caught in the idea that you have to edit everything all the time, even as you're writing, you won't do anything. Mm. And I think that's a trap that a lot of writers and a lot of musicians, songwriters particularly, fall into. So I always look at it from a standpoint of create something and judge it later, but have fun in the creative process first.
You're the best,
Willy. I like that. And Willy, where can people find out what you're up to, listen to some of those concerts, and just find out what's next for you?
Sure. My Facebook page, my band page, is at Willy Porter Music. And there's all kinds of schedule stuff there. I have my website as well. WillyPorter.com has my full schedule on it.
Love you, Willy. Thanks for joining us this morning.
Love you guys. Thank you.
Thank you, Willy.
Good to see
you.
Be
well. Great to see you.